Hi everybody, welcome to practice session number 2 on scoping a WAT topic. In the previous sessions, I've discussed why expanding and exploring the scope of any given, you know, essay topic is important. And in fact, in the last topic, in the last session, I also discussed, took a sample topic and we discussed, you know, we practiced on how to explore it, how to create different perspectives and generate arguments from there. And so this is a continuation of that same thought. Welcome to practice session number 2. Together we shall ace the VAT. My name is Anand Venkateshan. I'm an educator with An Academy. As you can see from my profile, engineering MBA profile from IIM Bangalore. And I think I've successfully had a track record of, you know, getting students admitted into best of institutions like IIMs, you know, ISB, schools in India, schools abroad. So that's the reason why you should listen to me. You know, a quick sort of word of advice. There's tons of educators like me on the An Academy platform. So besides, you know, the platform, we also release a lot of content on YouTube. And so you should follow us, our channel here, and make sure that you also, you know, keep up to date with what kind of information and courses we're launching on our Telegram channel. Right. So do follow us there. Right, with that intro, let's get into our agenda for today, WAT topic number 2. You know, here is the topic showing up on your screen. Cricket has spoiled the pitch for other sports in India. Just like the previous session, I would ask that anybody watching this video should pause it here. Try to consider the topic yourself, apply your own understanding and write a WAT. Come back and rewatch the rest of this video for a quick look or quick understanding about how you could explore it, you know, and generate points, right? So I'll invite you to do that. And if you guys have already, I hope that you guys have already written the essay and are here to quickly discuss it. Let's have a discussion how to explore the scope, right? This was the topic given to us, and I'm going to highlight portions of the topic, words within the topic that you should highlight, that you should break down and define very clearly. Like, for example, the first thing I want to focus on is, what does the topic mean, other sports, right? What do you mean other sports? Are we, you know, how do I explore this, right? When it says other sports, should I straight away talk about the next few popular sports? Like, are we talking about, you know, games like football? Hockey, which was very, very famous in India. Yeah. Maybe badminton, very, very famous nowadays. But also tennis. Yeah. There's so many games, TT, you know. And then another question that I have that I probably should think of is, should I consider, you know, indoor sports? Because cricket is an outdoor sport. So should I, you know, does this have to do with cricket being an indoor sport? And should I then compare it to outdoor sports and say, hey, you know, indoor outdoor mein difference hai, or right? I'm just showing you what all you could have explored, how all you could have explored, right? Other sport, right? What about online games, right? What about online games? Is that even relevant? Right? Maybe card games like poker, like games of chance, right? So where does it end? In fact, what about athletics, right? It's not really a sport, right? It's not really a sport. Preparing for the Olympics, preparing for Commonwealth Games isn't really a sport. It's in fact, you know, broadly classified into athletics. So should I compare cricket then with, you know, athletics, maybe the 100 meter sprint, or maybe the 500 meter, 400 meter, 800 meter sprint, maybe long jump, high jump, right? So what sort of a comparison should I make? So that's one, right? Does this help me? We will come to that point a little later, right? Similarly, the other thing you could have compared, right? You could have also tried to define the pitch. What does the topic mean when it says spoiled the pitch? What do I mean pitch? Well, if you follow cricket, then you'll know pitch is where you play the game, right? So in fact, it's not just where you play the game. It's the center of where the game is played, because the ground is essentially the area which surrounds the pitch, right? So when we're talking about the, you know, this topic, what does the pitch mean? Does it mean specifically the pitch used in cricket or are we using a larger term that has more that has a expanded meaning, let's say, right? So for example, what do I mean by pitch? And what is it that has been spoiled, remember? So do I mean maybe the players, you know, who plays the game? Am I talking about spectators or maybe even the viewership, right? Are we talking about that, hey, people who watch the sport, they don't watch it anymore. Maybe that's the problem. Or people who play the sport, people who used to like playing, you know, other games, don't like it anymore, right? Maybe something like that. You know, spoiled the pitch. Maybe we're talking about government regulation or government support for a game. How does the government support a game? Well, you know, state governments and the central government, they encourage, you know, participation in sport in many, many ways, right? Academies are there. There are government organizations which provide employment to people who play sports. Like, for example, if you remember, Dhoni at one point in time was a bank employee, was a central government employee of the railways. Similarly, right? So that's kind of support that the government gives it. It's also support in terms of recognition, right? Sports people are conferred with various prizes and awards, right? So that's also support that ostensibly is given by the government. Obviously, academies and financial support is also there, right? But when it comes to money, then there's also corporate sponsorship, right? So maybe the fact that, you know, maybe the fact that cricket, you know, gets so much sponsorship money, there's so much money that goes into getting the broadcasting rights or getting the, you know, the advertising rights for maybe a team or the jersey of the team, or maybe even on television and other media, right? So that means that these corporate sponsors don't have money to spend on other games, other sports, other avenues, right? So, okay, maybe it's about sponsorship. What else? Maybe what about spirit of the game, right? That's also possible, right? Right. Maybe what it does is that, you know, cricket has become mired in this controversy of fixing, right? And the moment we start thinking about if cricket can be fixed, if you can tamper with the, you know, spirit of the game, then why can't something similar happen with other sports, right? So maybe there is a rub off effect on other games, other sports as well, right? And I mean, spirit of the game could also have to do with probably you know, the fact that nobody watches the game means that nobody takes up the game now anymore, right? But then that ties back to, you know, players, right? So yeah, can you see that the moment you start imagining, then you're trying to sort of classify what the pitch is, and gives you plenty of ideas, right? It gives you, okay, maybe it has improved some of the things for other games, maybe it's spoiled other things for some of the games, right? So the fact that, you know, so much government support goes for cricket sometimes rubs off on other sports also, because the government is inherently trying to sort of balance the act, right? Okay, and by the way, spoiled the pitch could also be be about regulation, right? How is the game regulated? How is the, you know, how are government, how are, you know, are there bodies that you know, speak for players, speak for the sport, speak for the associations, etc., right? So that's also a thought that you should explore, right? So that's the pitch, right? And obviously there's also the word spoiled. Exactly what do you mean by spoiled, right? What you know, are we talking about decline or wastage, right? Maybe ruin, right? Maybe it's completely ruined sportsmen or athletes, right? Like, for example, if the moment you start thinking about ruining a sport, you're thinking hockey, right? Because both these games are similar, both involve using sticks that have handles, and you know, we were champions of one sport, you know, in the open era. We probably were early on in this century, in the last century, we were doing really, really well at hockey, but that's gone completely down the drain, because now the Indian hockey team isn't as good as it was. It isn't ruling the charts anymore, right? So there's ruin in terms of ability, right? Ability, There's also decline or ruin in participation, right? Maybe, you know, not only, it's not just the fact that we don't play hockey well anymore, it's also the fact that many youngsters don't start to play hockey at an early age, right? So we're not able to develop and cultivate or nurture that kind of talent. Okay. Spoilt in what other sense? Well, maybe competition, right? Maybe competitiveness, right? Because it always becomes an either-or, not sport in general. It's always cricket or the others. So maybe, you know, maybe that's one perspective you could have, right? In fact, you know what? If you look at the topic in itself, there are other questions you could ask yourself. Like supposing you could ask yourself about stakeholder approach. You could take the stakeholder approach to this, right? Who are the stakeholders? You know, when for example, you could ask yourself, cricket has spoiled or not soiled this pitch for whom? Right? For whom are we talking about, right? Spoiled for whom? Are we talking about spoiled for the players, the spectators, viewers, for example, or are we talking about the common man? Are we talking about, you know, rural India? Right? Because, you know, maybe we're talking about inequity, right? Maybe more athletes and more cricketers are coming out of certain states or certain geographies within India, not from the others, right? So some of these interesting ideas will come if you start to explore it inside out, right? Stakeholder approach, for example, could be about, hey, what do you mean cricket has soiled this pitch, right? Because maybe what that means is that there are state associations, there are that decide upon, you know, how much space should be allocated for sport. And since cricket is the most popular sport, more space or real estate is allocated for it as compared to the others, which inherently becomes like a chicken and egg situation because you're not giving it enough space, you're not building enough facilities, and inherently it will lead to a decline in that sport, right? And you could also compare it to some of the other sports which are doing well, right? Like for example, some of the newer Olympic or athletic sports like you know, like wrestling, like shooting, like archery. And immediately, you know, you realize that yes, spoiling has a whole different meaning in those games, right? So the idea in general is that before you start writing, you explore all of these perspectives and then you evaluate them on two parameters, right? I think that's what I'm going to leave you with in this topic, right? Once you've thought of various points, right? I know this will already have taken more than 5 to 7 minutes. But in the end, make sure that you spend another 2 minutes just thinking about, okay, which of these points is something that is unique, right? Something that most other participants in this process would not have thought about, right? Because if you can speak different things in your essay, I think that will immediately create a lot more impact. Obviously, keeping relevance into account, right? Hopefully, you're talking about the same topic, but you're bringing a different perspective into play. That's always a good thing to do, right? So, explore those aspects, those arguments, those ideas. Similarly, the second idea is also about impact, right? Which of these arguments is the strongest argument to either talk about, to either take a stance of it has soiled the pitch or it hasn't, right? Which of them is an outright, you know, winner in terms of proving your point. I think that those are points or arguments that you should consider and keep in your final WAT. Definitely the only two, maybe three such points, and everything else can, you know, can probably be ignored, right? Okay, so that's I thought an interesting way in that of scoping it. Remember, in the last session we talked about scoping it by using a framework, the PESTEL framework. In this, you know, topic, we actually use the words and we try to define every single word in the essay topic. And those definitions or those explorations that we embarked upon will give us 5 to 7 ideas, if not more. And that means that I can then choose basis impact and uniqueness, which points to continue as arguments in the body of my essay. Okay, I hope this you know, is giving you some ideas and helping out whenever you get stuck on WATs. Remember, I think the underlying aspect that most people face trouble with is, how do I generate points at one end of the spectrum, and at the other end of the spectrum is, how do I create an impact and not be all over the place, right? And I think scoping it well will allow you to balance both of these extreme positions of, I should have enough to write about, but I should also know when to stop myself and not go overboard in terms of arguments or points, right? Continue to explore things with the Unacademy app, because we did indeed turn the fortunes around for a lot of students, and you could be one of them if you join one of our more recent batches. You can see batches beginning in this week, weekday, weekend batches, as well as a verbal VA specific batch. Last few days to go for, this is 10% discount on the platform on our subscription. So do check it out, do avail of this immediately. And goes without saying, every Sunday we have a contest. This Sunday, 14th, happens to be the Unacademy Champions League. 5 o'clock is when you can participate. And why should you participate? Besides the thrill of just participating and testing yourself amongst others, there's also interesting prizes to be won, right? Subscription on offer. So if anything, it's only a half an hour of your life, but could get you, access to this beautiful app, right? So do check it out. And these are the kind of subscription plans that I have, that we have on our platform. The 12-month plans are what I want you to focus on. Comparison between the Plus and Iconic, the difference is that, Plus you learn with batches, you get material, you get tests and quizzes, you can, attend classes on a regular basis in specific batches. But all of this happens in group sessions, right? The only difference with Iconic is that besides getting all of the above, you get a personal coach, right? Now, that doesn't mean he teaches you separately, but he can mentor you separately about, hey, your performance is going awry, are you practicing well enough? Here's what you should do to get better, etc., etc. So a little bit of personal mentoring happens through this personal coach. And that's why you should consider going for an Iconic subscription. Right. In both cases, using my referral code AB01 gets you a 10% discount. Right. So make sure that you avail of that. Right. If you like this video, do give me a thumbs up. Do like this video. Do subscribe to our channel, and keep in touch with us on Telegram as well. That's the handle @CatForMBA. Until I meet you next, you guys be safe. Bye bye and have a good day.